you won't like me when I'm angry. Okay, so I watched the 2003 Ang Lee version of The Hulk. It was so bad. So bad, I had to make a video about it. Now, I went to see The Hulk when I was 13 years old. My dad took my little brother and maybe an older brother of mine to go see it. And probably my older sister. So we went and saw it, and I remember walking out of the theater just being like, oh my god, that was so cool, and this is like the best superhero movie I've ever seen. Wow, I was such a naive 13-year-old, let me tell you. Because after watching it, as an adult, as a film buff, someone who knows a little bit about superheroes and, you know, what to expect and what to hope for, wow, this movie was so bad. This movie made the first Spider-Man movie look good. And I hate Spider-Man. Fucking hate Spider-Man. So sick to death of Spider-Man, I could just fucking spray him with pesticide. First of all, one of my biggest problems with The Hulk, and by the way, this is Ang Lee, Life of Pi, that other movie he did, Brokeback Mountain, that's what I was thinking of. This is a very good director. I like most of his movies. This was horrible. This was fucking awful, okay? Anyway, going back to my original, you know, thought. One of my biggest problems with The Hulk is that the dialogue sucks. There is no good dialogue in this movie whatsoever. All of the actors are wooden. The characters suck. I immediately disliked Bruce Banner. Like, just immediately disliked him. There's just so much animal cruelty. Maybe Ang Lee was showing us how cruel scientists can be to animals and stuff like that, which I get, but it was so unnecessary to the fucking plot. I was like, oh my god, this is so horrible. Big fucking thing right here. The whole comic book cut and paste shit that they were doing throughout the entire movie was so fucking awful. I'm so glad X-Men First Class only had that one scene, okay? Because this was so distracting and just, it was just so stupid looking. Just stupid looking. Like, that's something I expect from, like, a superhero TV show, okay? I'm surprised Smallville didn't do that shit. And they probably realized they shouldn't do it because, oh, wow, it looks like shit. So fuck you, Ang Lee, in that regard. So at one point, Nick Nolte, who plays Bruce Banner's long-lost daddy, makes three enormous, already pretty big dogs. Okay, I don't know if you've ever seen a poodle and pit bulls in real life, but those are already pretty big dogs. Makes them extraordinarily humongous. Fucking humongous, okay? And by the time they actually fight the Hulk, he is already like 12 feet tall. And they're still big enough to overtake him. So these are like dinosaur-sized dogs, okay? Pretty big fucking dogs. Nobody in his neighborhood noticed that the crazy ex-con next door had three dinosaur-sized ravenous dogs that were kept inside a chain-link fence and didn't escape once. Nobody noticed that. At all. Nobody noticed three enormous dinosaur-sized dogs running through the streets of, I think it's San Francisco. I think that's where they are right now. I don't fucking know, and quite frankly, I don't fucking care. They don't know. Nobody notices three enormous dogs. Just, you know, tra-la-la-la, I'm gonna go eat a person today. How many people did they murder on the way to kill Jennifer Connelly's character? What the fuck? And who the fuck played the antagonist in that movie? That blonde douchebag who I absolutely fucking despise because I feel like this is what he's like in real life. The antagonist in the story, I fucking, this slimy douchebag has the balls to go into like an airtight fucking chamber that they are holding Bruce Banner in. Mind you, he is crippled at this point, not Bruce Banner, the slimy douchebag is half crippled at this point, and he just starts prodding him with the fucking like cattle prod. Oh yeah, I'm gonna make you angry, and then I'm gonna dissect you and shit. Then I'm gonna put you in this giant bathtub and make you even more pissed off, and then be so surprised when you break free because you have superhuman fucking strength that comes from, like, Thor. I mean, seriously, one of the things I love about the Avengers movie is the fact that Thor is the one who fights the Hulk because he's the only one who can take him in a fight because he's a god and he's immortal. This slimy douchebag is half crippled and he's just prodding him and he's so surprised when something goes wrong. What the actual fuck? You know, I wish I could go back in time and just sit in on some of these meetings that Ang Lee was having with, you know, with whoever. Like, oh yes, we're gonna do this, we're gonna do that, we're gonna make the crippled guy prod him with a cattle prod. It'll be fucking intense. It'll be so dark and gripping. And the final confrontation between Nick Nolte and Eric Bana was just so fucking awful. It was embarrassing. I was embarrassed for them. I was embarrassed for Nick Nolte, okay? And that's saying something. And Jennifer Connelly's character sucked. I hated Betty Ross. I hated Bruce Banner. They made me hate Bruce Banner. And I like Bruce Banner. I like the Hulk. He's sweet. And he doesn't want to be a monster. He just wants to be normal. And you made me dislike him severely. When he finally got hit with that gamma radiation, I was just like, oh, thank God, maybe he'll stop being such a bitch. Nope. He's still a bitch. Still a fucking bitch. When fucking Sam Elliott's character is just going on and on about how, like, why don't you remember anything? Dude, people repress traumatic experiences all the fucking time. You're in the fucking army. You've never heard of someone repressing a terrible memory? You haven't seen some shit that you maybe have repressed? Like, where are the psychiatrists in this? Like, nobody had Bruce Banner talk to a therapist about the fact that he saw his mother get stabbed to death by his father, who was trying to kill him. Are there no therapists in this universe? I cannot believe I sat through this entire fucking movie because I have seen a lot of bad shit. Okay? I have watched some terrible, terrible things. I've seen Lake Placid more times than I would care to admit because it's a classic at this point. Terror at the Opera. I have fucking seen Arena, okay? I have sat through some terrible fucking movies. And this is one of the worst ones. I'm 100% serious when I'm saying that. I'm not exaggerating when I say this is one of the worst movies I have ever fucking seen. Not even just worst superhero. Okay, this is as bad as the third X-Men movie. This is as bad as X-Men Origins. Okay? Cram all that shit together. Okay, this is as bad as Spider-Man fucking 3, okay? I am watching The Incredible Hulk right now with Edward Norton, and it's so much better. Like, it's not great, but it's so much better than this pile of shit that was The Hulk. Because at least in The Incredible Hulk, I feel like I'm rooting for Bruce Banner. They show him actually doing science-y shit. In The Hulk, Bruce Banner did not come across to me as a genius. He came across to me as a fucking idiot. They never showed him being smart. Ever. They talk about science maybe a few times, but they don't ever show him being intelligent. And then the Avengers, they show him being extraordinarily intelligent, which is Bruce fucking Banner. Not this whiny little bitch and then a semi, you know, sciencey guy. No. Mark Ruffalo, my hat is off to you. You did a fan-fucking-tastic job because you actually care about the character. I'm gonna go edit this video, try and finish watching The Incredible Hulk, and at some point sleep and dream of Mark Ruffalo. Live long and prosper. May the Force be with you, and stay tuned and turned on for more. What's my hair doing right now? It's got like this weird swoop thing. I need to stop fidgeting. Why am I so fidgety right now? My pants are falling down. I had to pull up my pants. Yee. So. And walking out of it, I was like, oh my God. Fucking hell. Fucking earbuds. They just fly everywhere. That was an impressive noise I just made. Totally gonna edit that out. What the fuck is on my cigarette? What other point was I trying to make? Fuck. Thank God Marvel got their fucking head out of their asses.